Hello and welcome to another video from Accounting How. In this video, we'll be looking at how to prepare a statement of changes in equity, in particular, how to record a rights issue of shares within a statement of changes in equity. If you haven't already done so, please take a moment to subscribe to the channel and like and share the videos. And you can also follow us on Twitter at Accounting How. Okay, here is the question for this video. You might decide to pause the video here and have a go at the question yourself if it's a topic you're familiar with, and then play the rest of the video to check your workings and answer, or stay with me and we'll do the question together. We're being told then the following information has been extracted from the equity section of the statement of financial position of Temple PLC at the 31st December 2021, issued share capital, share premium, and some retained earnings. And some additional information: the shares have a nominal value of 25 pence each. On the 1st of June 2022, the directors made a rights issue of shares. On the 1st of October 2022, an interim dividend was paid. And finally, the profit after tax for the year was £99,187. And we are required to prepare the statement of changes in equity for Temple PLC for the year ended 31st December 2022. And you'll see I have got my title ready: a who, a what, a when. Who, Temple PLC, what, statement of changes in equity, and when for the year ended 31st December 2022. I've also drawn out the layout that I need and I'm ready to begin. Now, the purpose of a statement of changes in equity is explained in its name. It's a document, a statement, that explains to any stakeholders looking at the accounts how the items within a company's equity section have changed during the year. The first thing I need to do is to create the columns I need. And I need a column for each item that this company, Temple PLC, has within its equity section. We have issued share capital, share premium, and retained earnings. And the extract that we were given was taken from their statement of financial position at 31st December 2021. And so I'm going to effectively bring those balances forward to the 1st of January 2022 and enter those as my starting position. Now I'm going to work through the additional information to see what has happened during the year and how that has affected items within the statement of changes in equity. The first thing we're being told is that shares have a nominal value of 25 pence each. Nominal value is sometimes referred to as face value. And the important thing to remember is that issued share capital is always shown, is always recorded at the nominal value. And that will be important in a moment. The second thing that we're told: on the 1st of June 2022, the directors made a rights issue on the basis of three new shares for every two held at an issue price of 40 pence each. The rights issue was fully subscribed. Fully subscribed, that means all of the shareholders, the existing shareholders, took up the right to buy these extra shares. And so I now need to work out and record the effect of this rights issue. My narrative, rights issue of shares, and my working. So I've got W1, working number one, and here I go with my working. The first thing I need to work out is how many shares are currently in issue in this company, the existing number of shares. We've been told that they have £320,000 of issued share capital. And if you remember what I said a moment ago, that is always shown at the nominal value. And the nominal value, the face value of this company's shares is 25 pence each. And recording issued share capital at nominal value allows me to work out how many shares the company has issued. So my working is going to be £320,000 of capital divided by the nominal value, 25 pence, tells me that this company has already issued 1,280,000 shares. Now I can work out how many shares have been issued under this rights issue. And you'll see my work income up here. We are told that for every two held, the shareholders were able to buy an additional three new shares. So you can see my formula. I've got the existing shares, the 1.28 million, and then divided by two, multiplied by three. So for every two that you've already got, you had the right to buy an additional three shares. And that brings us to a rights issue of shares of 1,920,000. It's important to remember, though, that the money measurement concept tells us that we always record things in monetary value in the accounts. So I now need to turn that number of shares back into pounds. The issued share capital, remember, is always shown at the nominal value. So the nominal value that's been raised from this share issue is 1,920,000 shares multiplied by 25 pence, which is £480,000. And that's going to be recorded into the issued share capital column. That has increased the issued share capital, the nominal value of these shares in total, not the nominal value per share, sorry, but the total into the issued share capital. And then the share premium. So if you have sold shares above the nominal value, which this company has in this rights issue, they were sold for 40 pence each, the share premium is always recorded separately. And if the nominal value is 25 pence and they've sold them for 40 pence, we know then, or we can calculate, that the premium on each share was 15 pence. And so they issued 1.92 million shares multiplied by 15 pence means that they have generated a share premium of £288,000. So the 480, you can see I'm recording in the issued share capital column because that's always shown at nominal value. And then the additional that they raised, the premium that they raised by selling them above the nominal value, is recorded in the share premium column. And there's my first item dealt with. Okay, the next thing, I'm going to record the profit for the year. And they've made it easy in this question. If I look at point number four, it says profit after tax for the year was £99,187. It is important to make sure you've got the profit after tax. Sometimes in these questions, they may give you, for instance, the profit before tax, and you'll need to find the tax figure, which will be somewhere else within the question, and subtract it to find the profit after tax. And profit after tax is retained earnings. If the company hangs on to this profit and the profit that they've made increases their retained earnings, and you can see I've just put that straight into the retained earnings column. And the final thing to do is to consider the dividends that they've paid during the year. And again, I'm going to need a working here. So you'll see I've put W2, working number two. And item three, it tells us on the 1st of October 2022, an interim dividend of 2 pence per share was paid on all the shares in issue at that date. So my working, I need to consider how many shares, not the pat, not I don't want a value, I want the number of shares were in issue on the 1st of October. So they had all of the original shares, and by that date they had done the rights issue of shares. So the total issued shares at that date were the 1.28 million shares they had at the beginning of the year, plus the 1.92 million shares that they issued during the rights issue. So by the 1st of October, this company had issued 3.2 million shares, and they rewarded these shareholders with a dividend of 2 pence per share. Just got to be a bit careful with my decimal places. So 3.2 million shares multiplied by 2 pence, or 0.02, means that the total payout of dividends for this company was £64,000. Dividends, that's the reward to shareholders, that comes from the profit that's been made during the year. So I'm going to deduct that from the retained earnings column. So the profit that they made, the 99,187, has gone into the retained earnings, but then from that they have paid out £64,000. Nearly done. Final stage is just to total off the columns. So at the end of the year, then at the 31st of December 2022, just simply total the column, They now have £800,000 of issued share capital. The share premium has gone up to £400,400, and the retained earnings balance at the end, 114,913. In the question, it does say a total column is not required. If it was required, all I would need to do is add a final column after the retained earnings, call it the total column, and then simply total up each of the rows. So the first row, I would add up the 320,000, the 112,400, and the 79,726. The second row, I'd add up the 480 and the 288, and so on. And that is it. That's how you prepare a statement of changes in equity, in particular, one where there has been a rights issue of shares. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, please give us a like, share, subscribe, and follow us on Twitter at Accounting How. If there's anything you'd like to see in future videos, please just let us know in the comments. Thank you very much.